I'm Chris Schwab, and welcome to this year's MADE Summit. I'm the CEO of ThinkMADES, a local cleaning business based in Washington, D.C., and Innova Local, which is a virtual assistant agency specifically tailored to cleaning business owners. So we help with your daily admin work and your phones. And I want to talk to you guys today about personal productivity for cleaning business owners rather than cleaning businesses. We talk a lot in our groups and community these days about how to run our business more smoothly, the systems that we all need for everything, and how to delegate. And these are all really important topics, but it starts with becoming productive yourself first before all this other stuff comes into play. Up to a high stage, until you've hired a full management team to handle things for you, you're a major driving force in your business, and you're involved in most of the day-to-day decisions and running of the business. And so it pays huge dividends to learn how to be productive yourself first. And so the goal with this talk today is to leave you with a personal productivity system that I and many of my top students and clients use every day to run their cleaning businesses, and to make you the most efficient MADE cleaning business owner in your city. So with that said, let's get started. I'm just going to talk about 60 seconds about myself, and then we're going to dive right into it. I just want you to have a minimum, a little background on who I am. So ThinkMADES is my cleaning company in DC. We were blessed with this huge initial period of growth. I was a first-time business owner at the time, and we grew to a substantial amount in our first year, up to about $20,000 a month in the first 90 days, in the first quarter of that year. And what I'm known for is, one, running my business remotely. I haven't lived in DC in about 3 years now. I've been living in London and Tokyo, despite it still being based in DC. And two, for running it in a very small amount of time per day, that's often hard for people to believe. And so I tell people I run my business in about an hour a day, but that's actually a small lie. And the lie is the opposite direction of what you're thinking. I actually honestly run it in about 10 minutes a day. What I do at this point in my business is I log on to Slack, I check in with my managers, and I say, is there anything you need me to do that you can't handle? Is there any fires I need to be aware of? Or is there anything else that I need to do for a few minutes? And 90% of the time, they tell me, no, go away, which is what I want. And so you get to a stage in your business, this is a normal stage that millions of businesses around the world have reached, where the owner is just not needed on the day-to-day basis anymore. And I teach people how to reach that exact same stage through the systems that I give them and through the virtual assistants that we provide for them. So I've helped hundreds of cleaning business owners reach a stage where they don't have to work day-to-day in their business anymore. So that's just a tiny bit of background on me, on the MADE service side. So the things that have really allowed me to get this efficient are being personally productive, systems, which you're going to hear me talk about a lot, but not in this talk, and delegation. And so we're going to focus on this first three-step system. And to get started, there's three crucial time management principles that I want you to be aware of. And we're not going to spend a lot of time here, but I want you to remember the names and go and research them after. The first is the 80-20 rule. This is a rule popularized by Tim Ferriss, although he did not coin the term, he repopularized it in today's culture. And it's the kind of principle that 20% of your efforts are going to give you 80% of your results, and 80% of your efforts are only going to give you that last 20% of your results. And it's a way to, it's a mental model to help you focus on the biggest customers that you should be going after, the people who are helping you get the most done, and in any area of your business, whether it's productive or not, to zone in on the few big things that give you the most results, so that you're not spending your time trying to maximize everything and getting burnt out. That's principle number one. We always want to apply this principle in our productivity and in our businesses to help us choose the marketing platforms, for example. So I see people on 10 or 15 different marketing platforms. They're on Bark, they're on Thumbtack, they're on Facebook Ads, they're on Google, Angie's List, Home Advisor. They're on a million different platforms, and they're not even doing $10,000 a month in revenue. And it's because you're spreading yourself too thin. Instead, you should focus on the top 1 to 2 paid and the top 1 to 2 free marketing channels and ignore everything else. This is the 80-20 rule in action, is you focusing only on the essentials that drive results. Parkinson's law, real quickly, is just the principle that work expands relationally to how much time you have for it. And so we've all been in school at one point where we had an essay of some sort due, right? And if you had one night to do that essay, you got it done one night. If you have 3 months to do that one page essay, it takes you 3 months to do that one page. And so we can set artificial constraints around ourselves to encourage us to get work done consistently in a timely manner. And the last principle is essentialism, a term coined by Greg McKeown, who wrote a book by the same title. And this is really about, it's a different variant on the 80-20 rule, but it's finding the core of your goals, the core of your life, the core of your relationships, and every part of your life and your business, the core essentials that are really important, so that you can maximize your time and your energy around those things and instead of trying to spread yourself thin. And there's a saying that, again, Tim Ferriss did not coin, but he popularized, called, are you chasing field mice or are you chasing buffalo? Are you chasing every little thing that comes into your field of vision, or only the big goals that you really care about deeply? And all of these three rules are a variant on the same core principle on doing what matters and doing what gives you the most results. So these are the three principles behind this simple personal productivity system that we're going to put into practice now. And it all starts with the ABCDE method of prioritization. And what this is you basically get a sheet of paper, you write down every to-do that you have this day, week, month, and in the future that you can think of, and you assign a letter grade corresponding to a level of importance to each task, so you always know what the most important tasks are. So your A tasks are your mission critical, super important, got to get them done right now tasks. Your B tasks are your important tasks that are, they're important and they need to be done, but maybe not as mission critical as your A tasks. And we go down the list. The further down you go for the letter, the less important it is. So your C tasks, there's still things that need to be done. And any task in business you can say is important, but they're definitely not as important as your A or B tasks. All the way down to E tasks, which are kind of like thoughts that you should do this one day or another, but it's just not on the list. I want you to, and we'll do a recap of homework at the end, I want you to get out a piece of paper and write down every single task that you need to do, because this is the core part of your productivity system, is to know what you need to be productive doing rather than just vaguely being productive and getting work done. And the second part of this is called batching. This is, again, you're going to hear this name a lot, something that was not coined by, but popularized by Tim Ferriss. This is a theme. And batching is a way of taking all of your smaller tasks that you need to do, whether it's following up with people or replying to a review or just doing or charging cards. There's all these small tasks that you have to do during the day, which are not necessarily time sensitive, meaning you don't have to do it the second that it comes in. You can put it a few hours later. And it's a way of freeing up your day so that you're not bogged down by all these small unimportant tasks, but that you can actually spend 60, 70, 80% of your day focused on just your A and your B tasks, and then the other 20% on these smaller, less important tasks. And the way it works is you basically choose 2 to 3 periods throughout the day. I wouldn't recommend more than 3. And you assign your smaller tasks as they come in to that part of the day. So they're just not eating up your day. And I give you my own cleaning company's batch schedule as an example. You don't have to use this one, but it's a helpful starting point. So we have texts, emails, voicemails that come in after hours. And so we want to reply to them in a timely manner, but we don't want to reply to them at 11 p.m. at night, right? So we batch our overnight tasks to 8 to 9 a.m. Those are things like responding to emails, texts, and voicemails, or reviews. That's calling customers who had a booking yesterday and asking them for feedback on how that cleaning went, and also pushing them to become a regular customer. We don't have to do that throughout the day. We all call them in that 8 to 9 a.m. period before they've gone to work. And then also submitting quotes and messages to the marketing platforms that we use, like Thumbtack or Yelp. Then our day is free for our A and B tasks, for any emergencies that come through, for any phone calls from new customers or team issues that pop up. Our day is free to handle all those issues as they come up. So we do those issues. And then as we get to the end of the day, small tasks popped up that we put into our batch period for the later part of the day and that we already had scheduled for it. And we do those tasks between 5 and 6 p.m. And those are things like scheduling teams for tomorrow, charging cards for the evening for the bookings that have been done that day, renewing any hiring or marketing ads that we have, particularly on Craigslist, and replying to any non-urgent messages or reviews that came in. So again, the purpose of this batching is to make sure that you get the smaller tasks done, but so that you can reduce the amount of interruptions that you have in a day from, you know, 100 down to 10 or 15. You'll still have interruptions, but this is a truly powerful way to reduce that. And the third part of this personal productivity system is the three-part to-do list and the Sunday night review. So I've used a ton of productivity tools and systems and to-do lists. And the core I found over the years that's helped me and my students is splitting things into three different lists. This is a do list. This is your current to-dos that you have to do this day and this week that you know are coming up very shortly. This is your batch list. That is all your smaller tasks. And this is an important point. Have a separate to-do list for your batch. There are things that you need to do that week that are small, and you could put them in your do list, but if you do, you will not honor that they need to be done in a certain time because you have free minutes during the day and you want to tick those off your to-do list, so you'll just do them. By putting your smaller tasks in a separate batch list, you're allowed to say, you're allowed to ignore it until that batch time period comes up. So have a separate batch list for all your smaller tasks, and don't you dare look at it unless it's time for your batch session. And then the last list that you're going to have is your watch list. These are all the future tasks that you know are coming up in the next few weeks and few months, or future projects that you haven't started yet, but that you want to do. All of those things, neatly organize them in your future watch list. These are things that you're keeping an eye on, or people that you need to reply to, right? But that they're not part of your main to-do list. So do is your current, batch is your small tasks, and watch is your future tasks. It's very important to have this set up because it helps you keep your ABCD method and your batching parts true and current. And the last part of this is the Sunday night review. It doesn't matter if you do it Friday evening or Sunday night or Monday morning. I do it Sunday night so I can start Monday morning knowing exactly what I need to do. But every once per week at the end of your week or the very beginning of your week, I want you to sit down with your three lists and reorganize your to-dos so you're up to date. Tick off all the to-dos that you did in your do and batch if you haven't already, and then move all the items that you have in your watch list that are now due this week up to your do list so that you know exactly what you need to do. So move all of them up to your do and batch list from your watch. Make sure everything is current, and then organize them using the ABCDE method so that you know when you wake up the next morning, you know what your A task is and you're going to get to it straight away. So this is the homework, just a real quick recap of this three-part to-do list. I want you to write down and organize every to-do that you have using the ABCDE method of prioritization. I want you to then choose your batch periods throughout the day and really honor those periods, and don't, when you have a free minute, try and do your smaller tasks. It's going to be you're going to have a huge amount of resistance to waiting to do tasks when you have free time. But I promise you, the break from the constant burnout and work that you're doing and the mental clarity you're going to have by training yourself to enjoy that downtime when you have it is going to outweigh the benefits of ticking that task off. Then I want you to organize, create and organize your three-part to-do lists. And finally, put it into practice for 4 weeks with no compromises. You're going to commit to yourself and you will do this productivity system for a month. You're not going to mix and match other productivity systems with this that you found. And you're going to be honest with yourself about how you're performing every day and every week. And I promise you, if you do this for 4 weeks, you will be profoundly more productive. It's these simple systems which drive the major results, not these big complicated ones. And just as kind of a bonus, if you have office staff already, if you have a manager or a VA, teach them this productivity system and then start using this with them for 4 weeks as well. Do a trial run with them. If they like working together like this, then you can implement this with your company and not just yourself. So next, because of the scope of our talk, I can't cover this too much, but I wanted to touch on it for just a couple minutes, is how we integrate this with our company's systems and our office staff, because this is a personal productivity system, but it ties in to your business's productivity and the way you run it efficiently as well. So this three-step process I mentioned in the beginning, this is step one. Step two is implementing company processes and systems. And step three is learning how to delegate and how to manage your teams productively as well. And there are systems for delegation that I cover separately. The goal is to unify these three parts into a cohesive whole so that there's blurred lines between your productivity and your businesses so that you're able to make everything run smoothly. This is the ultimate goal of this. And there's a few core systems that you're going to need no matter where you are in business as a cleaning business owner. I'd argue that you need a personal productivity system. You need a place to organize and manage your operations from. I use ClickUp and our booking software. You're going to have your own booking software. It's going to be Zenmate, I hope. but you're going to have your to-dos and your lists and all the other miscellaneous stuff that doesn't fit into Zenmate that run the back end of your company. I'd recommend that you use ClickUp because they have a great cleaning business template that you can apply. And a lot of the initial setup legwork is already done for you free of charge in 2 minutes. So you're going to have a central place for your operations. This isn't a system so much as it is an organizational software, but we kind of count it as a system because that's your mission control center. You're going to have a client attraction system where you get leads from. This is your marketing, right? Whether it's Facebook ads or Thumbtack, you're having leads come in from somewhere. You're going to have a sales follow-up system where you follow up with people and push them to book or push them to become a regular customer if they've already had a booking. I have a fully automated sales follow-up system that I want to talk with you guys about in a separate talk, which I think you'll really like. You can copy my one in 5 minutes if you want. You're going to need a client retention system, because if you don't have this, you'll find that you won't grow past a certain point, because you're going to reach a point where you're losing customers faster than you're gaining them, and you're going to be stuck. You need a referral and a reputation system to manage your branding. So these are the core marketing and sales systems that you need. You're also going to need an automated hiring system, but not 100% automated. It's like if you call a bank and you can't get a hold of a person because you keep dialing buttons and they keep giving you that automated voice. It's really frustrating and it degrades the customer experience. It's the same with hiring. Automate big parts of it, but you need to have the human element as well. So I have a really cool hiring system that I've automated partially just for our company. It's not a software or anything. But I've automated it so we automatically post to the job boards that get us the best applicants in our city, so city specific. And then once they express an interest and submit their application, they're automatically sent paperwork they need to fill out. They're sent a calendar link, right, to schedule their phone interview with us and their trial clean, and do their paperwork and their background checks and so on. We've automated all of that, which is really cool. But the phone interview is a person. The trial clean is a person evaluating them. And when they actually get started, they're dealing with a person. So automate big parts of your hiring system, but not entirely. And finally, systems for managing your teams and managing your managers when you bring on a VA or an office manager. These are the core systems that you need. And it all starts with a personal productivity system. So with that said, guys, that is a real brief introduction into how you can be personally productive and make your system in your main business run a little bit smoother. And I wanted to leave you guys with a very special offer. You're going to hear this from a lot of the talks. In my case, I make an argument that you really need what is inside. And so I have something called the Local Business MBA program. And what this is an in-depth, truly in-depth program. I feel like course is even the wrong word for it because it's so in-depth, that takes you through and rebuilds the foundation of your cleaning business. It helps you implement the exact systems I used and I mentioned on the previous slide, your marketing, your sales, client attraction system, sales follow-up system, hiring. All those are in the MBA program in addition to my marketing strategies and the templates that me and my students are using and how to delegate effectively as well. All of this is in my Local Business MBA program. It's a true in-depth program that helps you overhaul your entire cleaning business so that by the end of it, you're running smoothly, your business is running smoothly, you have someone helping out in the office, and you're consistently hiring great teams and consistently getting good customers. And this was last opened in March 2019 for our beta, and I haven't opened the door since. I've let a few students in who have approached me privately and made the case that they'd be good to join, but have not opened the doors publicly since March 2019, a year and a half ago. I'm going to be opening it later this year publicly again, and I wanted to offer you guys a chance to get in at a discounted price before I actually do that, to honor ZenMade in their summit and to you guys as the users. And so I've spent years working with hundreds of cleaning business owners to refine the strategies and the systems inside this course, and I'm confident it will help you. So go to localbusinessmba.com and click on Local Business MBA, the course, and you can use the code ZenMader, ZenMaider, for $300 off the course. This is off the current price of the course because the course is doubling once I publicly launch it. So you can actually get my existing course for 1/3 of the price that it will be a few months from now. So I hope to see you guys inside that. It's a wonderful community. We have a private student chat where we're all helping each other get unstuck and build our businesses together. And last thing is feel free to reach out. I don't bite. I'm very approachable and I'm very active in ZenMade and on the groups. So if you want a world-class US-based virtual assistant trained for cleaning companies, visit innovalocal.com and schedule a call with me and my team. If you're looking for the Local Business MBA program, go to localbusinessmba.com. And if you want a business health check where me and my team will go through each area of your business and leave you with a 90-day plan totally for free on how to fix each area of your business, then go to the Calendly link on the slide, calendly.com/innova-local, and book a call with us. Last but not least, you can reach out to me personally at chris@innovalocal.com or on Facebook. So I hope to see you guys inside. I hope this was helpful, and I really hope that you become much more productive because of this. Thank you.